Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to yet another video. So for today's video, I decided to create this beautiful colorful look because it is Pride Month. For those who don't know what Pride Month is, every year the month of June is dedicated to the LGBTQ community and celebrated as a Pride Month. This month is all about love, equality, acceptance and unity. So this is my small gesture to show my support towards the LGBTQ community. Before beginning the video, if you have not subscribed to my channel yet, please do it now and don't forget to ring the bell button so that you get notified every time I upload a video. So without any further ado, let's get started. Okay, so now I'm all barefaced. I have already prepped my skin well. So we will begin with the look. I will first go in with my primer. It is a silicone based primer. I warm it up between my fingers and apply it to my T-zone and then spreading it across my face and my makeup. Yeah. So now that I am primed, I will go in with my foundation. I'm taking the Maybelline Fit Me foundation. I'm in this shade 220 Natural Beige. All the products that I am using in today's look will be linked in the description box. So do check them out if you're interested in buying. Yeah, so moving ahead, I will take in a pump and a half of my foundation and I will be dotting it evenly across my face. Remaining on my neck. I'll go in with the Dump Beauty Blender and I'll blend my foundation. I'm not gonna go with my concealer right now. I'll first do my eyes just in case there is any fallout. I'll take a matte pink shade. I'll brief you with the look first. I'm gonna go into my crease with a pink shade. I'm gonna do my inner corners with yellow, like somewhere between orange and yellow, and then I'll be going towards green, blending all of it properly, and I'll go into my lower lash line with some sort of a blue color. So that is the look I'm planning for today. So while I do my eyeshadow, I will be talking about the Pride Month a little. And just a note, if you feel why I am looking down, it's because I have a mirror down here so that I will be able to do my eye look properly. Now, talking about the Pride Month, I feel that the concept itself is really nice. Like, the concept of acceptance, equality, and that love is not based on your gender. It is not important that you have to love someone of the opposite sex only. I feel not only this month, but we should be accepting all this like throughout our lives. Because I feel this world is not just a place for straight people. We have a lot of different sexualities and they should also be treated normal. We should not abide by the standards and accept the people for what they are. We should not try to change them. Because like for all the people in the LGBTQ community, obviously they didn't decide one fine day that okay, I will be gay today. No, it's not their choice. it is what they are. Now is a high time that we should accept it. So rather than making an issue out of it, I believe we should just read about it. We should get literate about it. I mean, obviously, it is not easy for the older generation, like our grandmoms, moms. Maybe it is not that easy for them to accept all these concepts, but it's okay. It is not like if they are not accepting it, so we have to follow the tradition. No, it is not like that. You can have your own opinions, and I believe if we change our viewpoints toward all this, then our future generation would take it really normally, like it wouldn't be a big issue for them. We are in a position to bring about this change, to make all this thing normal and accept people for what they are. If we are able to explain ourselves, it is fine. But if we are not able to accept the fact only, then also I believe just let it go. Just let people be the way they want to be. So before moving further, I'll just do my other eye off camera and be right back. So yeah, I'm done with my other eye. I added a pair of fake lashes and I added an inner highlight with a pretty lilac shimmer shade. It was my first time adding falsies and it took me good 15-20 minutes to do so, and I'm still not sure if I was able to put them properly or not. They look gorgeous. I mean, I wish I had such lashes. They look so pretty. But like on blinking, I feel like there is something on my eyelashes. Like obviously I have something, so I'm feeling that. It is feeling a bit weird to me right now, but I guess I'll get used to it anyways. But I am loving these lashes. To be honest, this was my first time trying my hands with colored eyeshadow. So I was like very worried if what if it goes wrong. So I thought that I'll just try doing a colored eyeshadow look and I'll record it. But I was not sure that it would turn out good or what. So I had decided that I'll just scrap this video. It would just be a practice for me. But I mean, I won't say it is perfect, obviously not, but like for my first time, I am loving the look. I guess I am very very obsessed with myself right now. So without blabbering, I'll just move on ahead and complete my entire look. So next time I'll go in filling my eyebrows. I'll brush them up with the spoolie. This COVID situation has just ruined my eyebrows. I mean, they don't have any shape whatsoever. I'm just filling in little bit of gaps that I have, but there is no shape to my eyebrows now. They are just going in whatever direction they want to. Now I do shape them sometimes. I try to at least. But obviously, I am not able to do it very properly, so my eyebrows are just going all over the places. I guess that'll do. I don't think my under eyes need a lot of concealer because the foundation has pretty much covered the darker areas. I just have a little bit of blemish here and here. I just want to give a bit extra coverage to that, and I add very little concealer under my eyes. I'll just go in with a brush for this. Pretty good concealer. It gives me medium coverage and I can build it up, but I don't like to build it up a lot. I just like a very light layer of concealer because I don't have a lot of problem areas, fortunately. For the concealer, I had used the Maybelline Fit Me, and I am in the shade 30 Honey. So I'm done with my foundation and my concealer. My eyes are done. So next in, I'll go with my compact. It is again from Maybelline Fit Me. And I am in the shade Natural Beige. Just powdering lightly all over my face, setting my base properly so that it doesn't creep. Dusting it on my neck as well, my forehead. I'm done with my base. Next up, I'll go in with my Sugar Face palette. So this palette is in the shade 01 Subtle Summit. It is from Sugar, the Contour Deforce Face Palette. This is my absolutely favorite palette. I mean, I just have this one palette and I don't feel the need to invest in any other palette. This is so pretty. Like, it gives you a subtle look. You can definitely build it up to your liking. So I am contouring my face. I'm done with contouring. Now I'll take the blush from this palette only. It is a very pretty coral shade. I'm just adding a little bit of color. I don't want anything to be overpowered. I want my eyes to be the star of the show, and obviously they are. Like, I am loving my eyes. I'm taking the highlighter from the same palette and just highlighting the higher points of my face. Pretty much done with my look. Just left with the lipstick. For the lipstick, I am going in with the Maybelline Creamy Matte range in the shade 657 Nude Nuance. This is my favorite nude lipstick. Now, because I had gone very bold on my eyes, I decided to go nude on my lips just to maintain the balance. Now I'll set my face. For the fixer, I'm using the Swiss Beauty Makeup Fixer. I'll shake it well. I'll go in with my beauty blender to just take off any excess product on my face. This is me done with the look. I'll just set my hair in place and be right back. So that was it for this video. I hope you like this look. My very first time trying my hands on fake lashes and such pretty colorful eye look. I hope you liked it. If you did, do hit the like button and comment down below. If you would like me to do any other type of video, please drop your suggestions in the comment box below. And also, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, what are you waiting for? Do subscribe to my channel and press the bell button so that you get notified every time I upload a video. Also, if you haven't followed me on Instagram yet, this is my handle. Do follow me on Instagram because I post beauty content on Instagram regularly. With that, I would end today's video. Bye-bye. Stay safe, stay healthy. See you soon.